So now this is how we can control our PC with our phone. In today's video, you will learn how to control your PC or your Chromebook using just your phone. Now guys, not only can you access your Windows PCs, but if you're in school maybe and have a Chromebook from your school, you can also access your Chromebook and work on schoolwork from anywhere by using this app. Now guys, this works on Android and on iPhone, but for this tutorial, I'm going to be using my iPhone 13. You can use the app to access your files and use your computer from anywhere, even if your computer is not in the same room as you. Drop a like on the video and subscribe to Fusion here for more helpful tutorials in the future. Now that I'm on the PC, the first thing we're going to want to do is head to the Chrome web store. I'll have a link for this in the description. And now that we're at the Chrome web store, you want to make sure that you sign into your Google account. Now guys, this part is important because your Google account is going to be what you use to communicate with the app on your phone. I'll explain more about this later, but if you don't have a Google account, just make one. It's really easy and free. And if you do, just sign in the top right where it says sign in. Now that we're at the Chrome web store, we're going to want to search the store for Chrome Remote Desktop. Now guys, I want you to choose this first result called Chrome Remote Desktop. You will know it's the real thing because it says remotedesktop.google.com. And by the way, there will be a link for this in the description and in the comments below this video. Now that we have found the plugin on the Chrome web store, all we want to do to install it on our computer is just come up to this blue button and click add to Chrome. Next, we're going to have a pop-up that asks us, do you want to add this to Chrome? It can manage your downloads and communicate with cooperating native applications. Again, you just want to click add extension. Now we can see a pop-up in the top right that says Chrome Remote Desktop has been added to Chrome. Now from here, you literally don't have to do anything else on your computer. Now we're going to hop over to mobile and we're going to check out the app that we need to install. All right, now that you're on the App Store, like I said, this works on Android or on Apple. Again, you're going to want to go to search and you're going to want to search for Chrome Remote Desktop. Now that I searched it, it's not the first result, but it's the second result, Chrome Remote Desktop. We're going to want to choose this one. You're just going to want to download the app on your phone. And now that the app is downloaded on my phone, we're going to open it up. So once the app is loaded up, there'll be a little blue sign-in button on the very bottom of the screen. It's kind of hard to see. So we're going to tap sign in, and now you want to sign in with your Google account that you just used to add the extension on your PC. So like we talked about before, you do need a Google account because you are adding an extension to your Google account, and then this app is communicating with that extension. Now that you're signed into your Google account that you installed the extension on, you want to hit continue. Welcome to Chrome Remote Desktop. Open Chrome and visit remotedesktop.google.com/access to set up your computer for remote access. After the setup is complete, refresh this page and you'll be able to access computer by choosing your device and entering the PIN. So we're going to want to head to remotedesktop.google.com/access. And now that we're here on the Chrome Remote Desktop site, we want to come to this blue button and click turn on. Next, it's going to have us name this device. So when we're choosing it on the app, we know which computer we're choosing. I'm just going to leave it as the default, which is Josh's PC. Hit next. And now you want to choose a PIN for your PC. This is important because we don't want just anybody to connect to our PC and access our files. Now that you entered in the PIN you want to use, we're just going to come down and hit the blue start button. A pop-up from Windows just came up asking if I want to allow it to make changes to my device. You want to select yes. And there we go. Now it says Josh's PC is online. So if we head back over to the phone and now refresh on the app, now it says Josh's PC is online. So now this is how we can control our PC with our phone. If I just tap on Josh's PC, enter in the PIN that I just chose, and you can choose remember my PIN on this device, all you want to do is tap the blue arrow. If it asks for permission to find devices on your local network, you want to make sure you allow that. So to show you guys how crazy this is, you can literally control your whole computer. I can move around, I can click on stuff, I could open up a new desktop. If you guys want to show the keyboard so that you can type on your computer, you want to tap the blue button in the bottom right, and then you want to tap Show Keyboard. Now we're going to search for Fusion here on Google, and let's head to FusionHere.com. Don't forget guys, you can always find all my videos on FusionHere.com, as well as order custom graphics. This is insanely responsive and really cool that you can use this from anywhere. If you want to left click, it's just a single tap. Right click is a tap with two fingers. Anyways guys, this has been how to control your PC or your Chromebook using your phone. I hope this video helped. If it did guys, make sure you guys drop a like on the video, subscribe to Fusion here, and leave a comment down below letting me know that the video helped you. I always love responding to my viewers and starting discussions in the comments. Anyways guys, this has been Josh or Fusion here. I'll see you guys in the next one.